Hi, welcome along to the Wonder Published Changemakers, a show that brings you the educators of tomorrow and in a way, the leaders of tomorrow. And today we have with us someone who's been adding value by creating, you know, videos on general awareness, her lessons on English, other things that take place on internet, and her travelogues also. We have with us the effervescent Alina Rais of Alina Rais Live. Welcome,
Thank
Alina.
You. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, so, please. I would love to be here and let's hear what you have to ask me. I'm really excited about this interview.
Actually, in a way, we are more excited than you because you have been using this medium for quite a long time now. And in a way, you, in such a young age, you're the veteran of this space. So if I'm correct, you started this channel in 2011. And you started being active somewhere around 2018, right?
This is 2011. I started using YouTube. Okay. I wasn't creating content. But 2018, January, I uploaded my first video. Then I uploaded a few more videos. And after that, I was away from YouTube for around 3-4 months. Then I came back. Then again, I took off for 3-4 months. Then again, I came back. And then finally, I started to work properly in 2020. So that is how we've done it, yeah.
All right. So the I think the growth rate must be very higher if you started in 2020 and we see you here. You're you're around 400K on in terms of subscribers only on YouTube. Not talking about other spaces. So speaking of these all these spaces, Alina, you have this sizable audience on YouTube, on Instagram, on Facebook, and I don't know about Twitter, sorry. So
Facebook blocked me. Facebook blogged me. Yeah. Somebody complained about my account that this is some fake ID and they actually removed me from Facebook. I'm not available on Facebook anymore and I stopped bothering about them. Okay. But yeah, I am available on Instagram and YouTube. That is
okay. Okay. Wonderful. Still, your audience is quite immense if I tell you because, you know, a lot of people, you know, engage with you. The comment section is full and it's brimming with activity, you know, all the time. So, and you, your engaging method is also quite personal. You tell people about yourself, your stories, your struggles. But still, there is so much curiosity about you. You know, one look at the Google searches and people are, you know, asking all sorts of questions about Alina Rais.
This is so funny. They ask about my age all the time.
Yeah. Correct. So, please tell us about your story. Like, what's the Alina Rais story?
Okay, I am a fan of inspiring people because personally, I know if I would say that I have had struggle, people wouldn't really believe me on that because people would feel that I am born in a very educated family and have money and you know, but that's really not my story. My story starts from a very humble background. We did not have a lot of money. And my father used to work very hard and my mother is a wonderful person and we are three daughters. So, you know, taking care of three daughters and schooling and everything is so expensive these days. And but I always used to be a very hardworking child. Even in my school days, I remember I could not perform very well. I was an average student, but around class 10th or 11th, I started to perform fine. And I realized that, you know, I really want to do something for my parents. My parents have always been my reason behind anything that I've done in my life. I just wanted my father to be extremely proud of myself. And that is still my driving reason. Whenever I am, you know, low and whenever I'm scared, there is this one person's face that I look at and I'm always charged with energy. So, of course, I wanted to do something for my father because I've seen him struggling so hard with life. And apart from that, he tried very hard to put me into a nice school. So getting admission in one of the best schools of Lucknow was sheer luck and hard work of my parents and their prayers. Because I wasn't there. I was out of school for 3 months. There was a period of 3 months when I was not going to school. This is class 6th, I remember. There were reasons to it. I wouldn't want to get into the reasons why I was not going to school. But I think this is something I've mentioned for the first time today on the internet. Yeah, so then the struggle started. I had this fire in me. I have to do something. And then I started working hard and I started seeing results. I could not speak properly in English. I could not speak at all. And then I went to a very good school. I could not speak to anyone. People used to be so fluent and I could not speak a word. So I started working on my language. I started working on my math, my other subjects, and gradually things started to change. So I realized there is potential in hard work. And yeah. I made that my charm. You know, hard work se kaam chalta hai, so why not? We can do that. Yeah. So uske baad I did CA. And I had no distractions as such in my life because my life was quite covered and, you know, protected in the home, the protection of the home. No distractions, became a CA like that. Then after that, I started my channel. I started working in a job and quit my job. And after quitting the job, I was actually going here and there without a clue what to do with life. I started my YouTube channel because I thought that I have a story to share. And that is how I started the channel. And after starting the channel, for the first 2 years, it wasn't working. It wasn't working at all because it never works for anyone. You start your channel, you will know. It doesn't work for you. It does not. But I did not quit because that is one thing that is unique about myself. I really believe that. I don't give up. That's something my parents also agree with. So I kept on doing it, And finally something happened. And God was like, "Theek hai, de dete hain, isko isko chahiye."
That's your hard work paying off. Yeah,
a lot of pain and a lot of hard work, and actually the life changed in 2020. My life changed and a lot of good things happened. So this is my story, nothing much.
Wonderful. So, you know, I was, you know, about to ask you about your this energy that you bring out in your videos, because a lot of time you impart your lessons through very innovative ideas, lessons are innovative themselves, because let's say when you're teaching English, because your series where you teach English is very famous. So you talk a lot about your struggles. Then you talk about how to be a better listener, better at speaking. So where do you come up with these ideas from?
Because my ideas are, thank you for this question. It's a very personal question. I would love to answer to that. I have a friend of mine, his name is Sahil, and my ideas are not really my ideas. These are 80% his ideas and 20% my ideas. So we work on the channel together and we really work on it together. It's just that I am the face of the channel, but I'm not really the owner of the channel. We both work equally hard on this channel. And most of the times the idea creation is his part, because I am otherwise also very busy with my life. So sometimes I propose some ideas and most of the times he's proposing the ideas. And then we work on them together and we make, like, there was this buddy system that we launched, where we created a portal. We asked people to add their email IDs in the portal and they started proposing their email IDs. And then we created a system. We created the website where website would randomly pick somebody for you. And then you can shoot an email to that person. And obviously the data is from the people who want to learn English. So website would find somebody for you and then you can send them an email and you people can start talking to each other in English so that both of you can grow. And now there are several WhatsApp groups going around in the world where people have found buddies. And there are 30 people and 40 people making group and all of them learning together. My God, it's such a success. And I remember we were just sitting and talking and we came up with this idea. It turned out so well, so well. So again, we work on the ideas together. I proposed the idea and he was the one who designed the everything, you know, designed everything around the idea, like website and everything.
So in a way you bring, you know, fun to the learning. Because because a lot of, you know, teachers and YouTube educators as well, they tend to become very, you know, very serious about what they're doing, and people, you know, tend to get intimidated by all the hard work that goes on. And and especially, you know, speaking about English in India, there's a stigma attached to speak English in, you know, B towns, where when you try to speak English, people will make fun of you. Can you tell us about, you know, some incident where you faced some sort of that sort of discrimination, let's say?
A lot of discrimination. This was class 7th. I was admitted into a new school and this was the best school of the city. all the girls, and it was a girls' school. And believe me, when you are studying in a girls' school, the competition is much more than a normal co-ed school. Okay. So everybody used to be so fluent and they were so good with the language. And I was just new girl in the school whom everybody kind of didn't like. Most of them did not like me. They were like, ye kahan se aa gayi hai? So anyway, I spent 1 year. I think that was the most depressing year of my life. That was a very tough year of my life. Every day going to school was like doing what to yourself? I can't explain that feeling. I used to hate going to school. Hate. Absolutely hate it. Because I knew that I didn't belong there. People don't like me. My teachers don't like me. Mm-hmm. No one likes me. And I'm just sitting in the room with so many people who don't like me. And I'm a very sensitive person. It used to affect me, you know. I'm in a place where people don't like me. Why am I here?
True.
I decided to, you know, change this. And I decided that people who are insulting me right now are going to be the ones who are going to look up to me one day. And it happened in 3 to 4 years.
Wow.
I was much better than them in studies. I was much better than them in English because I worked like crazy on my language. Mm. I used to listen. Anybody who would speak, I would just listen. I would just listen to that person. Kya bol rahi hai? Kaise bol rahi hai? Kaun se shabd istemal kar rahi hai? Everything. I used to listen to them. I used to learn from them by listening to them. And then I used to go back home. I used to speak to myself in English in front of the mirror.
Wow.
I used to practice. So I don't know why in class 7th at such a young age, I was so serious about these things. People are not serious at that age, right?
7th, 8th is... conscious about these things. That's strange, yeah.
Yeah. I was working already on my language and other things also. And that is how it started. And class 12th, I remember, I used to be the problem solver. Mm-hmm. Everybody used to come up with their mathematics doubts to me. Ki ye wala question solve nahi ho pa raha hai. And I used to correct my teachers also because I was very good with math and accountancy.
Teach maths as well. Wow.
I used to teach math. I just stopped teaching math just a little while ago because I had to focus more on other things. So I stopped teaching math. But math was, till class 7th, I was a failure in math. I could never pass. I could never get a 40 in math. So class 8th, I challenged myself that this year I'm going to pass in math. And I passed. I passed with, I think, 40, 42. That was the passing score. 40 was the passing score. I got a 42, I remember. Then after that, I challenged myself to get a 70. And then I got a 70. Then I challenged myself to cross 80. I scored more than 80. And then finally, class 12th board, I got 100 on 100 in math. And that is how it has been. Really, it has been magical.
Great. So you're clearly enjoying. We all can see that. And pardon us if there is some disturbance in the background.
No, not at all.
Yeah.
Can't hear you. I can't hear the background noise.
Okay, no. Great. Mm. So, Arina, just like I said, you're clearly enjoying this and your subscribers are enjoying this. So, as an independent educator who started independently, who must have gone through some collaborations, I'm not going to talk about them. But as an independent educator, you have given so much to your subscribers and mainly the confidence to speak in English. What would you say to this industry that looks up to the, you know, leaders like you who are bringing change from the outside?
Okay, leaders as in to the other influences?
To the people who are already inside the industry, let's say the education industry, who are there conventionally.
Oh.
Like the institutions.
Another very good question. Mm-hmm. I hate the education system. I don't like it.
You think it can be improved upon?
Oh, come on. There is 1,000,000% chance of improvement. Mm-hmm. Definitely. A lot it can be improved because first of all, the first thing that we need to cut down on is the pressure. Too much pressure. I mean, I understand some people can take the pressure, okay? But most can't. Most people can't.
True.
It's like you're making their life miserable. Students, children, I see how their lives are miserable because, I mean, even in the coaching institutes, I've happened to teach in coaching institutes also.
Okay.
And I remember, agar kisi bacche ko math nahi aati, usko chhod do na yaar, uske peeche pad jaoge, uski maa usko leke aayegi haath khench ke. इसको सिखाओ, इसको कुछ नहीं आता, ये गधा है उसके, लाइक यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट योर चाइल्ड इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर चाइल्ड, कॉलिंग हिम डोंकी ऑन हिज फेस. यू टेल मी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस विल दैट चाइल्ड कैरी 5 years फ्रॉम नाउ, 10 years फ्रॉम नाउ. हिज ओन मदर इज कॉलिंग हिम डोंकी. I have experienced such instances. I hate the education system and I really don't like the way most of the parents treat their children. And I know I'm saying that on the camera, lot of bashing is gonna happen, but that's what I like it. I want parents to be more supportive of children and I want them to understand that not all can be equal in studies. Studies should not be the parameter you should be judging your children at. They may be good at music, they may be good at sports. So pressure needs to be reduced. And then I think there needs to be a limited choice that you want to study. Imposing 10 subjects on one little child, I don't think that's good. I think there should be 3 or 4 subjects at the most, which a child should be studying of his own choice. And then let him do what he wants to do with the life. ठीक है? 10 subject पढ़ा के फायदा क्या यार? उसको सारे थोड़ी ना जानने हैं, उसको सारों में थोड़ी ना काम करना है. So pressure is one thing I would want to correct here. And then schools ka to aap khali mat poochho. Schools these days, oh my God. I mean, that is something if I start speaking about, I think I will go on and on and on and I'll be unstoppable. The system is really not good. There is a lot of pressure, lot of competition, lot of bashing within the class itself. Teachers insult other students, comparing them to other students. These things should be criminalized, according to me. If you're insulting a child in front of other children, you should be declared a criminal and you should be penalized for it.
Wonderful. So it can be said that in a way you are, if I use your word, decriminalizing the education system from the outside. Because, it's it's really necessary for, students to have the required confidence.
Yes, to learn. Confidence. I think more than the education, it is the confidence that they need.
Yeah. Oh. Because, one look in at your, comment section on YouTube videos, and people have not been, adequately given confidence. They have not been given proper courage, and nobody encourages them. So, in a way, as an independent educator, you're bringing that sort of thing in their lives.
I just want them to be confident, and I believe that every human being has the potential of making their own way. If you provide them with only confidence and nothing else, they will find a way. But you're providing them with knowledge, the knowledge that they don't want, zabardasti ki knowledge, theek hai, zabardasti ke working hours, zabardasti ka education, ye wo. And then finally, one thing that they really need to make it big in life is confidence, which is missing because tum to donkey ho. आप तो गधे हो, आपसे कुछ नहीं हो सकता सही से. तो अब बताओ बेचारा क्या करे उस पढ़ाई लिखाई का जो उसने इतने साल करी है.
Correct, you're right, absolutely correct. So in a way you're a motivational educator, if we put the two terms together.
Yes.
So Annalena, you're a CA yourself,
Yes.
And that's also very institutionalized, let's say. Something that you have gone through, institutional
professional
process.
Course.
Yeah, professional course. So, and a lot of people ask you, why didn't you pursue it? So I think I got some sort of answer from your previous answer. But still, let's say if CA Alina Reis, decides to move on with a YouTube channel, what are other possibilities for you and for the people who are listening?
Yeah. That's a very good question. I'll tell you. Just yesterday we were talking in the car about it. We were sitting in the car and we were talking, okay, what are we going to do with this? I mean, after 5 years, 7 years, there's going to be a point in my life when I would feel that, ho gaya yaar, bahut bana liye, ab nahi banane video. So ab kya kare? So we were actually thinking about it. But I don't really have a concrete answer for this one. I think what I really would want to do in life is to maybe create some kind of an institution which has the environment of support and confidence. Maybe some sort of a, I don't know, educational institute or maybe. Pata nahi abhi to, abhi nahi malum hai. But I would definitely want to use this subscriber base and build something which will be self-sustaining. Log hi log ko support karenge. Log hi logon ko aage badhayenge. And I will try and change the way people actually look at people. I think we human beings are lagging behind. Animals have more respect for each other. I really think so. Sometimes uselessly calling names, uselessly abusing others, uselessly forming opinions about others.
The dignity that you're trying to bring to the individual.
Dignity ki baat laga rakhi hai ek dusre ki. Sach mein, itna ek dusre ko bura bolenge, itna ek bina baat ka comment mein, mujhe bhi comments aate hain. Kaise aate hain batao? You are losing your beauty, why don't you get married? Okay. Hi, I block those people.
There's no correlation between these two things.
You're losing your beauty. Why don't you get married? Then you have such huge dark circles. Why don't you do some makeup before you shoot your videos? Okay. I took that as a serious matter. I got myself a concealer. I started applying a few things here. Then, you know, pata nahi kya kya bolte rehte hain. Arre bhaiya, kya milega tumko ye sab bolke? Pasand nahi aa raha hai, dislike maro, aage niklo. Meri naak teedi hai, mere ho chuke hain, meri aankhein main bhengi hu. ये बातें मुझे बता के क्या मेरी आंखें सीधी हो जाएंगी? आप मुझे बताओगे मैं भेंगी हूँ क्या मेरी आंखें ठीक हो जाएंगी, अलाइन हो जाएंगी?
That's the flip side of internet, you know. People are always going to be there, like.
But I actually, you know, you grow with it. Initially, it affects you, then it stops affecting you, and then you start laughing at it. I mean, right now I'm laughing at it, right?
Yeah.
I mean, how long can you cry on something?
So Alina, we are going through this, you know, this strange time, this pandemic. Corona has brought, you know, unexpected changes to everybody's life. We are working from home. Yeah. Students are not going, you know, schools are closed. Nothing is working. So, you know, there is a lot of uncertainty out there.
Yeah.
So have you seen, you know, any changes in the behavior of your students? Or, you know, what do you think? What will come out of this churning?
I think the world is going to change for better
because
people have learned the value of silence. People have learned the value of not doing anything. Har waqt har kuch na kuch karna zaruri nahi hota hai. You don't always need to be doing things. Hai na? Sometimes you just need to sit and not do anything. I think people must have realized the value of that particular feeling that you get when you're not doing anything. You're just relaxing. So I think the world is in for a great change, great deal of change. And apart from that, if I have to tell you, I would say, talking about particularly about my students, they are fine. They are studying. They are going on with their lives. Huh, they are a little skeptical about the way exams are going to happen because CA final, I teach CA final. So CA final students are worried about whether the November attempt will happen or not because a lot depends on that. If I were a student, I would have been worried myself because we study very hard for CA final papers and we want this to happen, right? So there is this doubt and uncertainty, but at the same time, they haven't forgotten to laugh. They haven't forgotten to enjoy themselves. They are enjoying, they are having a life of their own, themselves. And I think everything is fine, but I think pandemic has brought in a great opportunity to see our lives differently.
And, start afresh, correct.
To start fresh, because I have started afresh. And, you know, I used to go to office. People think I never went to office. No, I haven't. I used to go to office. When pandemic happened, I was a regular goer to office. I stopped going. Now I don't go.
Actually, that was my next question, actually. I wanted to ask whether, you know, there have been any personal discoveries or anything for you this lockdown period.
Great deal. First of all, my office stopped. I used to go to office. I used to go to a CA firm. But now I don't. It does not mean that I don't do that work. People still call me. You anyway work from phone now. Whether you sit here or you sit in the office, you have to work over the phone. And everything, government has made everything available online. You want to start a company, you can do it online. You want to shut down a company, you do it online. You don't need to run anywhere for that. So anything that I have to do, I can still do with my computer. But mostly right now, if I talk about earlier, YouTube was not this big a part of my life. Now it is. now YouTube is a major part of my life. And apart from that, An Academy, I'm teaching on An Academy CA Final. Wonderful. And that is also a great part of my life because I really enjoy working with those big children.
Big children.
Big ones. They are big in every aspect.
Okay. So has the number increased? I mean, the number of students who are coming to your channel, your viewership, has it increased in the past 3-4 months?
Yes, definitely. I used to be sitting at 35,000 subscribers. Now I'm close to 4 lakh, as mm-hmm. you just said. Mm-hmm. Right? So definitely people have increased on my channel. And
because of Corona period.
I don't think it's because of Corona. I think it's because of people do believe that it is happening because of Corona. It may be. I don't know. I don't know mm-hmm. where the traffic is coming from and why people mm-hmm. switch to YouTube. I don't watch them, right? Mm-hmm. But for sure, there is one thing that when you work hard enough on something, you find your forte.
Yeah, yeah. That's true. No, I'm not negating your hard work at all.
I'm not talking about you. This is just a general thing.
Coming from a point of view, like, do you see an upsurge in numbers because of the Corona yes. period?
Maybe. I'm not sure.
Okay.
I don't know.
So you're not in that analytical part of that channel? Okay.
No. But yeah, definitely. Earlier, my channel viewership was mostly from India. Now mm-hmm. it is from other parts of the world also.
Okay. South Asia, so, I presume.
Middle East.
Yeah.
Then America and a lot of Bangladesh and a lot of Pakistan is also happening to visit my channel. And they throw such lovely comments. They are really lovely mm-hmm. people.
Yeah.
Yeah, just send
it's a pretty borderless, peaceful zone, this YouTube educator space, right?
And I have always been very, YouTube has a lot of bashing going on. People talk shit about each other. But particularly talking about my channel, correct. I have always been a promoter of love and confidence and guiding each other, supporting each other.
Yeah,
I think people love coming to the channel because they like cleaning off whatever is going on in their mind. They come to my channel, they see me and then they feel positive, let's go on with life. That is the kind of vibe I've tried to create on my channel. Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. So Alina, you're already teaching at an academy. You're busy with your channel. But let's say people who are, the people who facilitate those changes, facilitate the change makers, mm-hmm. let's say, if they're looking mm-hmm. at this video, if they're watching you, what would you mm-hmm. say to them? What kind of, projects you're looking at? What kind of collaborations you're looking at in the future, let's say?
I don't really, this is good or bad, whatever, I don't know. Mm-hmm. But I don't really care what I'm speaking. So I'll mm-hmm. be honest here. You have this Airtel girl. Huh? Airtel girl? Have you seen?
Yeah.
I want to be that girl to some brand. Okay.
For this space. You want to be the space of this space, right?
Koi bhi chalega. Koi bhi big brand chalega. I want to be like Vodafone girl. I would love that. So something like that, just kidding, but seriously, why not? But apart from that, if I have to actually talk to brands, I would say that I would love to work with people who are mm-hmm. it's a very diplomatic question. How should I be answering this? I like working with nice brands, and especially mm-hmm. I like working with people who give me my creative freedom.
Wow.
People who don't impose themselves on me. And this is the first thing that I always mention whenever a brand approaches me, since I'm an influencer myself. Correct. People approach me, right? And if I like their product, I promote their product. The first thing is that I should like their product. If something is cheap and sleazy, I would never, mm-hmm. never mm-hmm. promote it. Secondly, the thing that I always say to them right in the beginning is that I will be working with my own creative freedom. You will not mm-hmm. impose any of your ideas on me. Because mm-hmm. otherwise, my channel is my channel. Nah? You're coming to me for help.
Correct.
I mean, why should I be creating something absolutely looking around you? No. I'm going to be doing something in my way, and I will promote you also if I will like your product. So mm-hmm. I definitely demand a creative freedom, which mostly people allow because brands are, they understand.
Yeah, they understand your strengths. Yes. Correct.
But mostly, if a typical brand I would talk about, I think the brands which really care about people. But this is such a vague thing to say. So I don't really know how to put that.
Mm-hmm.
see, you understand, na? When the brand really cares about you, it reflects in their product. It reflects
that
in their product.
That goes both the ways.
So I would love to work with brands who really care about people, really care about their customers.
And I see a point in, you know, wanting to become, at least, you know, in any way, to become the face of this this space, because there is a lot to explore here.
Maza aega, papa kitne khush honge. Whether is we karna chahte.
I'm sure he's already proud of you, no?
He is. Life my first time. I became a CA, he never said I'm proud of you. But just recently, there was this guy who shot a video on me. He covered me in his YouTube video. Okay. I sent that video to my father and he said, I'm very proud of you. I said, hey, CA bani tumne bola.
Wow. So I'm sure you'll send this video as well to him, right?
I will send your interview, entire interview to him.
So, Kalina, as we come to the, you know, fag end of this conversation, I would, and I am glad that you brought the, you know, your father's point of view, because I wanted to ask how has been the personal life, because some sort of popularity has been there for you, so you are in a way, you are in a way a celebrity of sorts now. So what kind?
No, this is very embarrassing.
Well, that's,
I don't consider myself.
But still, you understand what I'm saying. So, how has been the personal life? How has it been affected? Or
personal life has not been affected at all. It's going great. My sisters are enjoying in Canada. They've shifted there, and they don't plan on coming back. And apart from that, life is going quite smooth. Mashallah, say. Papa is doing fine, Mama is doing fine, and both of them are very happy with my success. Whatever little success that I have, they're happy with it. And apart from that, I keep sending them a lot of gifts, because as I told you, they are my reason. So I send them gifts. I want to buy them a good holiday, but Corona has stopped me from doing that. But everything is, touch wood, really good, mashallah say. Everything is fine. Health is good. That is top priority for me always. Health is good, and it's going fine.
Wonderful. It's going fine. So, you know, to end this on a fun note, why don't you define Alina Reis in 3 words? It's a very trivial sort of questions, but just 3. Okay.
I would. Yeah. Okay, 3 words. So they have to be 3 separate words.
Yeah, yeah. Why not? You can improve.
Okay. 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 First one would be ambitious.
Great.
Not in a very personal way. My growth. Yeah. Ambitious would be about India, about the world. So ambitious. Secondly, now this is a phrase, but no, I think I have 1 word instead of that phrase. Weird.
Yes. Really? Okay.
I'm weird. I mean, it's thoda sa crazy. Because if you meet me in person, there is a good chance that I will not speak to you at all. I'll be in my thoughts. And, you know, 2 hours can pass not speaking anything. So, it may be very awkward. Okay. Very awkward also. So, weird would be second. Third would be loving. Loving. Very, very loving.
Okay, so a weirdly ambitious, loving person.
Yes.
All
right. Weirdly ambitious. yes.
Okay,
yes.
We can rephrase it in any way possible. But
whatever way.
Thank you so much.
No. Seriously, you asked me such nice questions, and it was really lovely talking about myself for so long. It's like, you know, being in the spotlight for so long. It was really nice speaking with you. I hope this interview inspires people, and I really want to bring about a change in the way people think more than anything else, because if you change the way you think, your life changes.
Absolutely.
So I really hope people benefit from this interview, and all the very best for whatever you are doing right now. And seriously, good job.
Thank you so much, and thank you everyone for watching. We'll see you in the next episode. And thank you, Alina, once again.
Thank you. Bye-bye.